when Flora opened her eyes, she saw the sky outside, hanging in tatters like old wallpaper. Scorched earth, no flower grew, no creature crawled. Out of her bedroom window, she tumbled, stumbling through the wasteland, looking for one last green glimmer of life. But there was nothing, and all the time, in her ears, was the sound of hammering, hammering, hammering. Jumped out of bed, tore open the curtains to let the bright spring sunshine smiling down on a lush green world. In a tall house on a tall hill with her father.
Flora, has something terrible happened? You've left your room, you're outside in the fresh air. It must be the end of the world.
I had a bad dream. What are you doing?
Never too old to fly. night in a thunderstorm. I love to watch it soaring and dancing free as a bird, brilliant as a once in a lifetime, I will change the world, and I can take my place in eternity with my heroes, Franklin and Edison and Tesla. All my life, I have wanted to leave something behind. Last night I built it, I hope the hammering
In the tall house on the tall hill, the lights shone day and night. The heating was warm and snug. From the belly of the machine, Flora could hear the hammering of the struggling sky, like a telltale heart fighting to be free. But her father told her not to worry.
Thank you.
Then one day, the doorbell rang. It was the polar bears. Come in, then the doorbell rang again. It was the monkeys. The kangaroos.
Everybody's not my list.
Sky, fighting to be free.
Where are you going?
To fly a kite.
Flora!
You're never too old to fly a kite.
Flora opened the door on a raging world, where the remains of the sky tore open in a storm.
Thank you.
Father saw the valley below the house had flooded, so the top of the hill was now an island. Here and there, having no choice but to brave the anger of the sudden sea, people huddled in boats. Flora had almost forgotten the kite in her hand, but the wild wind found it easily and snatched her into the air. But the kite tangled in the leafless branches of the very last tree, and a bird was disturbed.
Thank you.
10 times bigger, its greedy mouth gaping, pulling the last bright rags of the sky down into its swelling belly. And suddenly, it was moving upwards again. The sky engine gave a terrible mechanical cry that could be heard all around the world. And suddenly, from out of its mouth, unleashed, came a solid blue column reaching up to heaven. The sky was free again. The ice froze afresh, the trees blossomed anew, and green redeemed the earth so that the animals could go home again. In the weeks that followed, Flora noticed that her father was looking older. He walked more slowly, and he slept longer, and he didn't want to go outside anymore. But one day, she persuaded him to fly kites with her.
I've had an idea.